Joseph, can you tell me a little bit about the clubhouse?
Our clubhouse space is for young people between the ages of 18 to 21. And this is a space where young people can sort of focus on their maintenance phase in their recovery, right? So maintenance meaning that these young people have access to different things like outdoor activities, indoor activities, things that keep them sober. So we know that a lot of young people who come into recovery, they sort of, in that space, they sort of talking about historical trauma, they talking about collective healing, and don't know how to navigate the world, right, sober. So we want to make sure that we provide a space where young people can learn how to navigate the world sober. I run a group called HOME, and it's called Health Opportunity, Motivation, and Education. So it's a space where young people can learn alternatives to using drugs and alcohol, right? So something that we do, I think that works really, really well with young people is I teach things like kickboxing, I teach dance, I teach how to how to maintain your money. I also teach how to make food.
That's
right? Awesome. Something simple as making food, right?
Very how universal.
To maintain, right. How to maintain health. These young people just feel collectively supported, collectively liberated, and it makes them believe eating fast food is not the only way to stay healthy, right?
Right.
But there are other ways that they can stay healthy when it comes down to food and other stuff. So it's really awesome. When young people first come to Clubhouse or they want to be a part of the youth recovery program or whatever the case may be, what we do is I call it an engagement intervention, right? So I sit down with the young person, I talk to them about life, mm-hmm. Just what's going on, right? And sort of helping them build that trust, right? My job is not to go straight in and be like, so what are you using?
You really want them comfortable.
I want them comfortable. Mm-hmm. I want to know what's going on. I want to know, how is life going for you? What other things are happening in your life? Mm-hmm. And having that conversation. And then sort of connecting what's going on in your life connects to your substance use. And then we can sort of figure out how we can support you in your recovery, right? And so once that happens, then we do an intake, which allows the young person to get to know their counselor. Mm-hmm. So the counselor that you're going to be paired up with is your
match.
It was your match.
Yeah.
So that counselor would do an intake with you, and then that counselor will be your counselor, your primary counselor, mm-hmm. which is awesome. And the good thing about that is they get to know you. Mm-hmm. Let's figure out what our plan is going to be. Let's figure out how we can set long-term goals, how we can set short-term goals. And that's just the first session. Setting those goals is just the first session.
Right.
And the good thing that we have, and I love this about our program, so this is the fun part about our program, but once a young person get in our program, once they meet those short-term goals, we have this thing called contingency management, which I love. Mm-hmm. And contingency management meaning that young people, when they get a negative toxic screening, right, they get points, and each point equals a certain amount of money, and they get to cash that money in for gift cards, which means that, and it's a way of saying, you know what, you did well, you met this goal, now how can we meet other goals? So the counselor is also there to support them every step of the way. There's young people who pop up. Sometimes it's like they don't have a one-on-one session, but they just pop up oh my God, I'm having a problem. I feel like I'm going to withdraw. I need some support. And there's a counselor right there to see you.
Mm-hmm.
Your primary counselor will be right there to support you. And then the substance engagement specialist, the goal is for me to continue to check up on you and make sure that you are doing well in your sobriety. We have tons of groups, which is awesome for young people. I call that the collective healing space. We have different groups like early recovery, which young people can talk about their substance use and like why they're using, and they talk about trauma. Mm-hmm. That we also have a group that talk about sex and sexuality, which is awesome. So we have multiple groups. We also talk about emotional wellness, mm-hmm. And how that relates to a young person's recovery. So we have those groups. And then in the Clubhouse spectrum, we have like fun, interactive other groups that we have. We have like Vogang, we have, which is really awesome. We have a gamers group that young people can go into. We have tutoring. And all this other stuff that young people have access to once they are in our program. If they have doctor's appointments, I go with young people to doctor's appointments. Like, I'm there to help them fill out paperwork. If they don't understand something, I'm there. Like, I'm their go-to person. When I go home every day after work, I literally feel, like, liberated. I think that's the perfect term for it. I feel like I have changed someone's life. And there's moments where I even get emotional doing my job because I know that young people can make it, you know? And when they do, that warms my heart. And when young people are feeling supported and liberated, like, that really touches me. If there is a disconnect with young people, I literally go home and I'm like, what am I doing wrong? Mm-hmm. How can I connect to this young person on a different level? What can I do to meet this young person halfway? What can I do to meet this young person where they are, mm-hmm. right? And I make sure I do it. So like the next day I come up with a plan. I want to strategize how to meet this young person where they are, how to make sure this young person trusts me as a staff member, mm-hmm. right? When that does happen and when their life does change, mm-hmm. I feel good about that. Like, that really warms my heart, and it makes me want to do it again, mm-hmm. and again and again and again and again until all of our young people are feeling well supported and liberated. So that's just something that's just something I think about every time I get home. Is like, did I do my job today?
Right.
Like, was it successful? And if it wasn't, what can I do tomorrow that's different from today?
I know recovery could be difficult because substance abuse among the LGBT community is much, much higher. The Clubhouse here at the center is so important because of the support it provides young people who are struggling with recovery from addiction. With the support and guidance of Joseph and the others at the Clubhouse, I know many people will be able to keep their minds off of negative factors and just engage with life.